Welcome to the screencast of NetRecs app, an interactive network medicine tool for disease module identification and drug privacy. After a short intro to NetRecs, I'm going to present how by NetRecs app we can reproduce the results of pulmonary embolism use case shown on the tutorial webpage of the app. We can identify potentially repurposable drugs in silico by carrying out the following three steps in NetRecs. First, a heterogeneous biological network is constructed by integrating data from multiple biomedical databases. This heterogeneous network contains domain knowledge that could be used for drug repurposing. Next, the constructed biological network is mined to derive disease models associated with the disease of interest. Finally, drugs with known targets that are contained in or in close vicinity to the extracted disease models are prioritized. An advantage of our platform is that users can engage their expert knowledge at two points where seeds need to be selected. So we are now in CytoScape, and I'm going to show you step by step how to identify drug targets and drugs for pulmonary embolism. The first step is to import a network from NetRecsDB. We can do this by the import network from public database function from CytoScape app. From there, you need to select NetRecs as data source. And in the import panel, you have a couple of options. You can select what type of associations you want to include in your network. For drug repurposing, you need to at least check gene disorder and disorder-disorder associations to be included. You can also select which of these two databases you want to include for your disease gene associations. For this case, we select both of them. You can then name your network here and press import. If you already have some other loaded networks in CytoScape, it is recommended to always select create new network collection when prompted. When asked if you'd like to create a view for your large network, it is recommended to select not. After the requested network is loaded, you need to select the node corresponding to pulmonary embolism in this network. To this end, you can go to NetRecs app and run quick select function. From there, you need to first select your node type, which in this case is disorder. Then you can just type in pulmonary embolism disease. You can add it to the list and then press select in network. So in this way, you have selected pulmonary embolism node in your network, as you can see here. Now you need to select all genes associated to these disorders in the current network. To do this, you can basically go to NetRecs menu again. You can go to get disease genes, and from there, you can name your new network. So to be easier to track the entire analysis later, you can call it PE genes here. As you can see, a subnetwork containing all the pulmonary embolism genes is created here. To run disease module identification, first you need to select seeds, which are normally genes associated to the disease. Here you can select all genes from this network by simply going to NetRecs, select nodes, all nodes of specific type, and then select gene as node type there. Now that we have selected the seeds, we are ready to identify the disease module. There are a couple of algorithms integrated in our tool for this purpose. For pulmonary embolism case, we use Diamond. We can run this function from NetRecs menu under disease module identification menu and run Diamond. A window pops up to select the algorithm parameters. You should set the number of iteration to 20. This parameter corresponds to the size of disease module. Then we keep the cyst weights to the default one. You can again enter the name of your network here. If you want to also retain all the edges in your disease module, you should select this option as well. The obtained disease module looks like this, and the cysts you started with are already selected in the network. You can assign a different color to the cysts if you want them to be more distinctive by simply going to the Style tab there and setting a bypass color to your selected nodes. The final step is to prioritize drug candidates targeting the disease module by using one of the drug ranking functionalities. Here we want to show that even without including the initial disease genes or seeds from the return module, we can identify relevant drugs for pulmonary embolism. To this end, you need to select non-seed nodes from the table. So here, as you can see, we have an attribute with the name seeds, and the ones that are not seeds, you need to basically select them, then right click, select nodes from selected roads, and they are now selected in your network. From the drug prioritization menu here, now rank drugs with trust rank functionalities. So we want to include only approved drugs which directly targets our selection. So we need to select the first two options here. We keep the damping factor to the default setting. We also set the result size to 100 to basically limit the results to only top rank drugs. Here you get a network including your selection from the disease module together with the top rank drugs targeting. From the node table, you can find the rank of written drugs. You can sort the drugs based on the ranks here. Among the 50 top rank drugs, we find, for example, bemiparin, edoxaban, apixaban, heparin, and a couple of others, which are indicated to reduce the risk of stroke and systemic embolism and are known to be used to treat pulmonary embolism. Furthermore, 5 drugs registered in clinical trials for evaluation in treatment of pulmonary embolism, including alteplase and enoxaparin, are found on top of the rank list. Some of these drugs target the coagulation factor X or F10, which is not among the initial set of pulmonary embolism associated genes, but is found in the disease module. F10 is a key enzyme in the coagulation cascade. Plasminogen, or PLG, another member of the disease module that helps dissolving the fibrin of blood clots and behaves as a proteolytic factor, is also targeted by some of the mentioned drugs. To sum up, in this use case, we could extract disease-related mechanistic pathways which contain possible targets for candidate drugs. We could also identify drugs which in practice are prescribed for treatment of pulmonary embolism or are under evaluation in clinical trials.